Morning everyone, we are reading this chapter Lost Spring second part. I am just giving you a quick recollection of what we have read. We have read it so far here till here. So what we have read? We have read that Mukesh is taking Anish Jung to his house. His family is working as bangle makers and it is a famous occupation of whole of the Firozabad. So they lived there and they lived in a very pitiable condition. They have a very small hut for themselves, and then at least they'll give us a first hand information about how they are living there. And there is a girl who is the wife of Mukesh's elder brother, and she's just very young to get married. And then the lady is there, she said that it is a destiny of bangle maker's son to be bangle maker because they do not know any other occupation. And then she got to know about from the elder one, the head of the family, that he was not able to provide even a good education to his both of his sons, and even a good house for them. He was not able to renovate the house while working for so long years as a bangle maker and a tailor. So that's how their pitiable condition is. And they do not know any other occupation. When she talked about to the young people of that area, she come to know that they cannot try any other occupation because they do not know any other occupation. If they really want to do that, they were dragged back by the middlemen, by the police and by the politicians. Nobody is there to help them. Nobody is there to give a hand to them, and they cannot start their any occupation of their own. So then, listening to them, I see two distinct worlds. One of the family caught in the web of poverty, burdened by the stigma of caste in which they are born. The other, a vicious circle of sahukars, the middlemen, the policemen, the keepers of law, the bureaucrats and the politicians. So when she listened to all these young people of that country, that town Firozabad, she just came to see two worlds there. Okay, two distinct world. One world is of the family of those people who are caught in the web of poverty, who are just caught in poverty, and they are burdened by the stigma. Stigma is Hindi mein jaise hum bolte hain kalank. So they are burdened with the stigma of being poor. Okay. And the other one is, other world is the vicious. Vicious matlab means that malicious circle, that circle of the sahukars, the middlemen, the bureaucrats, okay, the businessman, you can say the politicians. So these are two distinct worlds here. Okay, and what happened if one world, the world of poor, really want to uplift themselves, they are suppressed by this other world, that world of these all people, bureaucrats and all those people. And that stigma, what stigma she's talking about, we have come across some rag pickers sometimes. It is a very general thing. It happens with us all the time. You have seen these these people, these rag pickers coming to your house searching for these all things. Okay, so what happened? We used to shoo them. We used to get away with them. We will not trust them. What will we say? That they are maybe thieves. They will be stealing something from our house. We just shoo them away. We do not give a thought that they are also human beings. Whatever they are doing it for their livelihood. We look down on them like they are thieves already. We have that prejudice in our minds for these rag pickers, that they are thieves and they have come here to steal the things. They will steal something from here, and we do not let them around our surroundings, around our houses. We do not want them to be around our houses searching for the things. Okay, so that is a prejudice in our mind already. We take them granted to be as thieves. Why? Because they are poor trodden people. They are poor. They cannot stand for their own self. Maybe that is the reason that we took them for granted. We do not think about them. So that is happening here. They are poor. There is nobody to stand for them. There is nobody to support them. And these bureaucrats, these sahukar, they suppress them more so that they cannot uplift themselves at all. So that is happening with them also. Okay. So what happened? Together they have imposed the baggage on the child that he cannot put down. So she's talking about the children, both the world, they have together imposed the force, that baggage of poverty, on that that little child that he cannot put down. Put down means he cannot get rid away of that that burden. When a child grows, he or she doesn't know to which caste or to which religion or to which society do they belong. if it is us people who tell them that you are Hindu, you are Muslim, or you are Rajput, or you are this and this and this, we are the people. But this child just grow like a human being only. You do not have already a caste, you do not have already a religion, okay? It is us people who make them realize that this is these are, you belong to the society. And the children of these bangle makers, they are already being decided that they have to be bangle maker by their family. Okay, they put that burden while a child get birth, okay, and they are overburdened with that that bangle making thing, and they have to carry that burden throughout their life. They cannot think about any other thing. And if they really want to do the second world, the world of these bureaucrats and sahukars, they make sure that they would not be able to get away from that burden. So that is happening with these children. Before he is aware, he accepts it as naturally as his father. To do anything else would mean to death. Yes, it happens with him, but it happens with us also. How do we accept it that, okay, fine, we are Hindu, we are Muslim? Because we see our people around that they are doing this thing, okay? So we accept it readily. We do not question that, are we really Hindu? Do we question it from our parents? That why should I speak Hindi, or why should I speak this language, or why should I follow this religion? We do not question, because we take it as naturally as our fathers has taken it, or as our other member of the family has taken it. We do not question it, because it is natural to us that what our people around are doing, that we will do. So these children, the people around these children, what they are doing? They are doing bangle making. They are making bangles all the time, everywhere. So they will accept it readily. They will accept it naturally that, yes, this is their occupation. And they could not do anything else than that. And daring is not a part of his growing up. And he has given that kind of upbringing that he could not dare to just refuse it. He could not dare to not to accept it. Why? Because these poor people, they do not have a right to speak for their own right, okay? Because nobody give them that opportunity, nobody give them that right to speak for their own rights. We take them for granted that, yes, they are poor, who will think about them? This is our prejudice, this is everybody's prejudice, this is everybody's thinking of these people, okay? So that is happening with these all children. To do anything else would mean to dare, and daring is not a part of his growing up. When I sense a flash of it in Mukesh, I am cheered. I want to be a motor mechanic, he repeats. So when she say, when I sense, what does that mean? That, you know, when she saw that flash, that light of hope, or the ray of hope in Mukesh. Why? Because he dared to speak different from her own community. He really do not want to be a bangle maker. He wanted to be a mechanic. So that was a ray of dare. That was a ray of hope she saw in Mukesh, that yes, the coming generation like Mukesh can change their fate by denying to be a bangle maker, by refusing to be a bangle maker, and to try any other occupation. So he will go to garage and learn. Then he says that he will go to garage and he will learn there. So he's very practical about his approach towards his goal, that I will be going to garage and I will learn these all things there. But the garage is long way from his home. I will walk, he insists. And then Anish asked him that garage is very far away from your home. How would you go? And he has already determined in his thoughts, in his opinion, that yes, I will walk. That doesn't make any difference for me. I will walk and I will go to the garage and I will learn. So do you also dream of flying a plane? He is suddenly silent. So then Anis asked a question, that do you ever dream of flying a plane? That you have a dream that you will ride those cars and buses and all those things. Have you ever dreamt of flying a plane? He became suddenly silent. So here his silent is very important here. Why? Because he said no. He says, staring at the ground in a small murmur, there is an embarrassment that has not yet turned into regret. So when he says that, no, and he just looked down and he was embarrassed at that time. Why this embarrassment is that? Because he knows his limits, he knows his boundaries, that he can somewhere, he can think of be a mechanic, he can think of be a driver to a bus or to any vehicle. But to fly an aeroplane, it is beyond his limitations, it is beyond his boundaries, he could not do that. So that is why he was embarrassed, because that little child is also aware of his limitations, aware of his capabilities, aware of his poverty, I would say. He knows that it is beyond his capacity, it is beyond his dreams. He could not dream of flying an aeroplane. So that is why he was embarrassed at that time, that this thing is beyond his reach, okay? And then And it is not a regret for him. He could not regret that because that's how the environment has provided to him. He could not regret that, okay? But still, he is trying to do something different from the rest of his community. That is a commendable thing for him. He is content to dream of cars that he sees hurtling down the streets of his town. Few aeroplanes fly over Ferozabad. So he says that, you know, that he is content. Content means he is satisfied of thinking of, dreaming of, you know, driving a car and driving a vehicle. And to have an aeroplane, to fly an aeroplane, it is a very distant thing for him. Why? Because few of the aeroplanes fly over the Ferozabad, because there are no much aeroplanes fly over the Ferozabad. He had never seen those frequent flights of those aeroplane, so it is not so frequent dream for him. So it is enough for him to fly cars.